Hello everybody and welcome to our time of prayer and praise on the fifth Sunday of Lent. Our time together today is being recorded in Bole Church, St Martin of Tours in Bole. We begin with our opening prayer. As your family, we join in this time of prayer and praise today, not because we have to, but because we want to. We're here to share in worship, to share our prayers, remembering the service we are called to and the needs of our neighbours. We have as our example your Son Jesus, who chose not to rule but to serve, who gave of himself and you a love so strong that it flowed like a river from his hands and his feet. Our collect for today. Gracious Father, you gave up your Son out of love for the world. Lead us to ponder the mysteries of his passion, that we may know eternal peace through the shedding of our Saviour's blood, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's sing or listen to our first hymn, Meekness and Majesty.
Meekness and majesty, manhood and deity, in perfect harmony, the man who is God, Lord of eternity, dwells in humanity, kneels in humility, and washes our feet. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty. Bow down and worship, for this is your God. This is your God. Father's pure radiance, perfect in innocence, yet learns obedience to death on a cross, suffering to give us life, conquering through sacrifice, and as they crucify, praise Father, forgive. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty, bow down and worship, for this is your God, this is your God. Wisdom unsearchable, God the invisible, love indestructible, in frailty appears, Lord of infinity, stooping so tenderly, lifts our humanity to the heights of his throne. Oh, what a mystery, meekness and majesty, bow down and worship, for this is your God, this is your God, this is your God.
We bring before God those things which in his eyes sadden him and reduce us, make us less than we really are. Look upon us, O Lord, and let all the darkness of our souls vanish before the beams of your brightness. Fill us with your holy love and open to us the treasures of your wisdom. All we long for is known to you. Perfect what you have begun, we pray, and what your Holy Spirit has awakened in us to ask in prayer. We seek your face, turn to us and show us your glory. Only then will our longings be satisfied and our peace be perfect. Amen. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Bible reading today is read for us by Ros Moss, who is church warden here at Bole Church.
The Gospel reading taken from John chapter 12, verses 20 to 31. Among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we should like to see Jesus." So Philip went and told Andrew, and the two of them went to tell Jesus. Then Jesus replied, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. In truth, in very truth, I tell you, a grain of wheat remains a solitary grain, unless it falls onto the ground and dies. But if it dies, it bears a rich harvest. The man who loves himself is lost, but he who hates himself in this world will be kept safe for eternal life. If anyone serves me, he must follow me. Where I am, my servant will be. Whosoever serves me will be honoured by my Father. Now my soul is in turmoil, and what am I to say? Father, save me from this hour. No, it was for this that I came to this hour. Father, glorify thy name." A voice sounded from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing by said it was thunder, while others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus replied, "This voice spoke for your sake, not mine. Now is the hour of judgment for this world. Now shall the prince of this world be driven out. And I shall draw all men to myself when I am lifted up from the earth." This he said to indicate the kind of death he was to die. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Ros. Let's spend a few moments now considering what that reading means to us today. But before that, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we pray that you would lead us from where we are to where you would have us be. Amen. So today, as we continue our walk with Jesus through Lent, we draw very close to the week of the Passion of Jesus. We call it Holy Week. And it begins a week on Sunday. This Sunday was once called Passion Sunday. But what does the word passion really mean? Well, we often hear it. We often hear that word, "Oh, I'm passionate about something or other." And I wonder if I were to ask you that question, what are you passionate about? Well, if I look up in the dictionary, the meaning is strong, barely controllable emotion, or an outburst of anger, or strong enthusiasm, or the suffering of Christ during his last few days. In today's gospel reading that Ros has just read to us, there seems to be a great paradox in Jesus' response to the Gentiles, the Greeks, who came and asked to see Jesus. After Andrew and Philip went to Jesus and told him these people wanted to see him, Jesus responded and challenges us today. "Whoever wants to serve me must follow me. Whoever serves me, the Father will honour." Jesus was prepared to face what lay ahead. It was his passion. He must do what his Father had called him to do. He knew, though, that before victory must come defeat. How many times have you encountered the situation where what looks like failure results in a message being spread which far outweighs the initial response and failure? So what is our response to Jesus' words? We must follow him. We must experience the ministry of service to which each of us is called. Now, my ministry differs to your ministry. You're a unique person with your own gifts and your own talents, and that's to be celebrated. That's as it should be. We each have been gifted with special ministries. It would be sad if all of us were the same. God made us each unique. And as we consider our own ministry, perhaps we must bear in mind the metaphor Jesus uses to describe his ministry. Jesus uses a very simple analogy, that of a seed. Now, when we sow a seed, there comes a point where the seed ceases to exist. It becomes soft and collapses as the new life germinates within it. If the same seed had fallen onto a path or onto stony ground, it would have been trodden underfoot or gradually died from dehydration. Translated into human terms, such a death is meaningless. A life has been lived and it's ended. For many people today, that is the sum total of what they expect from life. They will be born, live, die, and then that'll be the end. As Christians, we believe that there is more to life and there's more to death. Jesus himself didn't relish the path that he was summoned to follow, but how could he ask that he would be excused? Neither could he ask that his followers be excused the path also. But what Christians know is that it isn't the path to suffering, but the path through suffering. For its own sake, suffering can do as much harm as good. We've all met people whose lives have been blighted by suffering, in whom bitterness and resentment have taken hold. The question they pose is, well, why me? Why is it always me? On the other hand, there are people who have allowed their suffering to be tuned into the suffering of Jesus. They haven't chosen the path of pain, but having encountered it, they've made a choice. I'm not going to be beaten by this. I'm going to turn the negative into a positive. In Retford, our local town, Karen Land, she was a firefighter. She raised money for cancer even though she was dying of cancer. I'm sure you know of others who have rarely been those beacons of hope for us all. It's never an easy choice. Very few of us can make that choice. But those who can, they set an example to the rest of us, sowing the small seed of hope which they themselves cling to. A seed once planted in the earth actually ceases to exist. It becomes something better. It becomes a plant which will produce many more seeds. Why would Jesus choose to use such a common and ordinary illustration instead of an exotic, extraordinary one? Well, it's because all Jesus' parables and illustrations were aimed at meeting us where we are in life. And God speaks to us today in ways that we can understand and in which we can participate. We can understand the example of a seed. We can relate to it. We can relate it to Jesus, who is buried in the ground and rises to something much better, an eternal life, not just for him, but for us too, for all humanity, for all time. Jesus doesn't just mean the example for himself, but for all of us. We all have parts of us that die so that new life can come about. We metaphorically die to the security of the womb and we're born into this world. We go through the stages of early childhood and they give way to the maturity of teenagehood. We die to the qualities of teenage life and we become adults. Loss in all its forms can lead to something positive. the next stage of our lives. Perhaps you can think of more. It's hard, I know, but there's always positive. It's the natural part of being human, of being alive. Yet what humankind values most and what Jesus calls us to is not just dying to ourselves for our own growth, but even more so to die to ourselves for the sake of others. So what needs to die in us that God's life might grow in us? Do we need to let our own talking die so that we can listen to others? Do we need to let our prejudice and judgments of people die, especially those in our families and our workplaces, so that God's image of them may be seen? Do we need to let our overactive minds find a quieter way of being so that we may hear God speaking to us in the scriptures or in silent prayer or in those special heaven-touching earth moments? We're coming towards the end of Lent. For some people, they take up things that they give up for Lent or even take on for Lent, but it might have begun to fall apart for you. Now is the time to recommit, to making them bear fruit, to pick up the pieces and continue on. Maybe it's time to ask ourselves how we can die to ourselves so that others might live more fully. In that way, on Easter Day, may Jesus find us to be people who respond to his call to follow him and imitate him, following the one who died for us so that you and I may have life. Amen. Let's listen to or join in together singing our second hymn once again.
Jesus Christ, I think upon your sacrifice. You became nothing, poured out to death. Many times I've wondered at your gift of life, and I'm in that place once again. I'm in that place once again. And once again I look upon the cross where you died. Humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life. Now you are exalted to the highest height, King of the heavens, where one day I'll bow. But for now, I marvel at your saving grace, and I'm full of praise once again. I'm full of praise once again. And once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life. Thank you for the cross, thank you for the cross, thank you for the cross, my friend. Thank you for the cross, my friend. And once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life.
So we come to our time of prayer. Barbara, our treasurer here at Bole Church, will lead us.
Let us pray to the God who loves us and understands our needs. God of mercy, we pray for all church leaders, teachers and pastors, and all who are being called into particular ministries, both lay and ordained. We pray especially for any who are wrestling with the demands of such a calling, that they may be given courage to offer themselves in your service. Let your name be glorified. Let your will be done. All-seeing God, watch over the nations of the world in all their plans and actions, conflicts and disasters. Guard the children, guide the leaders, and give us all your peace. Let your name be glorified. Let your will be done. God of love, be present in every heart and home to cherish, to challenge, to reassure and to comfort us. Let your name be glorified. Let your will be done. God of wholeness, we bring to your love those who are weighed down with suffering or imprisoned by their fears. Ease their burdens and give them the strength to bear what cannot be avoided. Let your name be glorified. Let your will be done. God of life, we bring to you those whose earthly lives have ended, that in your mercy they may have everlasting peace. Let your name be glorified. Let your will be done. Gracious God, you are always so much more ready to give than we to receive. Open our hearts and minds to live the costly way of love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And continuing in prayer, let's join together in the words that Jesus taught us, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Let's sing or listen to our third hymn. We want to see Jesus lifted high.
Might see the truth and know He is the way to heaven. We're gonna see Jesus lifted high. We're gonna see Jesus lifted high.
Thank you for joining me today. Please join me next week as we celebrate Palm Sunday. But now, our closing prayers. In our waking and our arising, in our eating and drinking, be the first thought that enters our head. In our walking and journeying, in our working and serving, be the first thought that enters our head. In our sowing and harvesting, in our rejoicing and sorrowing, be the first thought that enters our head. In our resting and relaxing, in our sleeping and our dreaming, be the first thought that enters our head. Amen. And now may we walk in God's ways, always knowing what is right and good. And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.